There's a funny little feature in this game that you can check the database and it shows you the yellow thing is where you are, the green dots are the videos we've seen, and the red ones are the ones we haven't seen yet. Volume missing. What is this? Huh. So there's still quite a lot of videos to see. Yeah.
No, he doesn't have any tattoos. He has a scar down here near his stomach, past his hip. Cut himself with some glass. That was before, a long time ago. He looks just like the photo. He's not got his glasses on here though. He takes them off with the camera. But he needs them to see properly, you know. He has to read a newspaper or a menu in a restaurant. Not books so much, or watching TV. He likes TV.
You'd think he'd use his glasses to read books as well. I mean, books are kind of the same print as a newspaper. But whatever. Let's talk about fennel. Ooh, chit chat. How's it going down there? You done? S.B. S.B. Who's that? I can't type anything, like, no profanities, unfortunately. I can only type yes or no. So I'm not done yet. Okay, I'll hang a bit longer. Buzz when you're ready. I think I know what this is. This is the point where the game deems that I know maybe enough to end the game and see the credits. And I kind of want to do that because then I can log in as a different user and get all the entries, like all the, instead of 5 videos, I get 15. I want to search a bit more because I still have some terms left, and then I'm going to chit-chat. I still want to talk about Oxford because Simon was there. But one of the twins didn't know about it. Well, he didn't go to Oxford. That's the point. He lied about it. Maybe. I don't know.
There was a conference. Something to do with double glazing. In Oxford?
That's helpful.
It was supposed to be a secret. Just because Simon is dead, it doesn't mean I have to give up all his secrets. It doesn't have anything to do with what happened to Simon. No one murdered my husband.
Except me.
Because he cheated his expenses for a romantic weekend in Oxford. Mum and Dad never knew what was going on. We got so good at it. We were so in sync that we'd use each other to cheat. If one of us had a hangover, the other one would go to school. Whoever was best at a subject would sit the exam. There were lots of differences between us. Some things one is better than the other at.
What a plot twist, though. I mean, there were two people living one life. It's a very hard thing to manage, especially at school. I mean, what if one of the girls talked to some people there, like her friends at school, and then the other twin showed up and had no idea of the conversations? But I guess that's why they had very strict diary policies, so that they could never screw up the story. Interesting. I wonder why they were doing that, though.
Mother wanted me to grow my hair long, but I kept cutting it myself. I wanted to look like my reflection. She always had short hair when she was little. Mother would hide the scissors, but I would find a way. Cut it with a bread knife, something like that. My reflection would always leave her house and go on adventures, but I never could. Mother taught me at home, and I had books and TV. TV was magical, but it was only on when it wanted to be, so I spent a lot of time reading books.
So this was when she was living with Florence and thought Florence was her real mother. Anything on books that might be relevant? 8 entries.
Sorry. The picture, the way it's drawn, just reminded me of the books we used to read as children. I read those fairy tales over and over, and they were so real to me. Rapunzel was my favourite. My brain is just full of it. How many of these in colour?
It's probably because you related to Rapunzel so well when you were a child.
And the glaziers. I worked there some weekends, and Simon had a part-time job there too. That was Eric's generosity. He was always good at helping out other people's children. Simon was quiet, more thoughtful than the other boys. Even then, he had a sense of craftsmanship. It wasn't always rushing stuff. Boys that age are just running around like headless chickens most of the time. Yeah. Plus, he had that look. He looked like a fairy tale prince from one of my books.
What an evil smile. Demented. Super, super crazy.
Yes. The first time we saw each other, it was strange. We both realized at the same moment, I think. We must have seen each other before, but there was this instant when we first realized it wasn't a reflection.
When the twins met each other.
Was staring back. I think I was 5. It was my birthday. My reflection was wearing a party hat and waving. I knew what party hats were from books. And it suddenly occurred to me, today must be my birthday. I waved back and we just spent ages waving at each other and copying each other's movements.
It sounds so unreal that this is the story that happened. I wish it was based on a true story, but it's really good. And I wish I could see all the entries. I'm trying to figure out why her mother didn't want to keep the other twin. I mean, the mother thought the other twin had died, right?
A mobile phone? Yeah. Well, they have one for the glaciers, but it's only for work. I can't remember the number. Oh, it's in the kitchen. I saw it plugged into its charging cradle.
Considering that they were twins and they were basically living one life together, people didn't actually know. This would make it a perfect setup to murder anyone because one of the twin could do the murder and then the other one could just be around people and have a very solid alibi and no one would be any wiser. So maybe one of the twins murdered Simon and the other one just told them, hey, I wasn't in the house. I was with these people. And they were like, hey, okay, because you don't have a twin. Although you do.
I did. Well, we met when we were 17, both working at the glaciers.
Twins. Okay.
Twins? Really? Are you really asking me that question?
Ooh. Am I wrong in thinking that? Oh, she's acting like she doesn't know. Which means I'm getting close.
Are you out of your mind?
Nope.
Twins?
Yep. Twins. Fucking twins.
There were always princes and princesses. They were the special people, more important than the other characters in their stories. We knew we were like that. Twins. Magical. We were the princesses. We had a poster of Princess Diana from the newspaper up in our attic. Had pride of place. And underneath we used to put all our special things. When her engagement was announced, we were obsessed with everything she did. And later, when her life went so bad, we felt for her. Her divorce last year just kind of drew a line under things.
Might be another long shot, but more on Princess Diana?
Yeah, we were 17. It was a nice wedding, people said. Simon looked very handsome in the photos. His parents paid for everything, but he's an only child, so it was important to them. It was what they called a shotgun wedding, but if you looked at the photos, you couldn't tell. The dress was beautiful. It looked like Princess Diana's. The train wasn't quite as long, though. There's a great photo of the bridesmaid helping to carry it out of the car.
Let's talk... I wonder if talking about the pregnancies will get us anywhere. What about pregnancy?
Hannah had a miscarriage. This was late in the pregnancy and it left her infertile. Felt like the universe had corrected its course. We were aligned again. But Hannah and Simon were still living with his parents. They were married. Simon had a job at the Glaziers now. Eric had given him a full-time position after he left school.
And then what? Tell me, woman. What about birth? One of you had a child. Nope. No birth.
Yes, I'm fine. I'll be sick again. This happens some days. I'm pregnant.
Right now?
It's a morning sickness.
Okay, so you're pregnant right now.
No. Well, yes. You found out on my birthday. I told him I was pregnant.
I thought you didn't tell him. What is going on?
When I arrived in Glasgow, I was exhausted. The streets were empty. I was driving badly. And I hit a taxi.
Oh.
Not a big crash. Just paintwork. The guy was so pissed off because I didn't have a driving license on me. But when I told him I was pregnant, he made sure I got to the hospital so they could check me out. It was fine. The hospital must have details when I was looked at. There's a scratch on the car.
You didn't have a driver's license because you technically didn't exist. One of you didn't exist, so it was probably the other twin that had all the paperwork. Tell me more about the accident and what happened there. Accident. Maybe not. Hospital?
Ask the hospital.
Oh, great. I'll go and ask them, then.
I don't see how it's hard. We've established I was in Glasgow when he was killed. We've spoken with the hospital.
So one of the twins, the pregnant one, went to Glasgow, while the other twin murdered Simon. Right? That's how I see it. I can see that there are 10 entries. I'm just gonna do it. I'm just gonna chit-chat, and I want to see all the entries, because you can see the you can continue searching the entries. Okay. Hi. Yes. Can I type anything? Anything at all. Buzz when you're ready. Okay, I'll call. Hi. Hey, you done? Yes, I guess? Good. So you understand why your mother did what she did? Not really. That's understandable, Sarah. You can always come back again. I'll be outside. Log off and meet me over the road. So I'm Sarah, and she mentioned that the baby that was miscarried would have been named Sarah or Ava. So maybe the woman that's pregnant now had Sarah. You can always come back again. I'll be outside. And meet me over the road. But I'm trying to search Sarah, but there's not much. Sarah. Okay? Missing. One entry.
I thought it made me sound suspicious. It's not a normal thing to do, to drive to the other end of the country. I wanted to keep it simple. I know it was stupid not to tell you everything. Saying I spent the night in Glasgow when my husband went missing, I thought it would, distract you from what was important. It's different now. Now he's...
So you wanted to distract me from what was important? Nothing on distract. What was important?
It's like I told you before. I drove. I took the car and drove. I don't have my own car, but I have a spare set of keys. I just drove north. I wanted to think, put some space between me and them. Everything I told you before is true. I stopped at Glasgow. I was tired, exhausted. I pulled out and I hit a car. My car was okay, but I was worried about the baby, so I went to A&E to get the okay. Everything was fine. Slept in the car. When I woke, I tried to call Hannah from a payphone. She wasn't answering. And then I decided to drive back. I had decided that she was more important to me than Simon.
So she basically slept with Simon, got pregnant, and then wanted to kind of get away from Hannah and Simon while Hannah was busy murdering Simon? Because he slept with her twin sister? Maybe, that's kind of how I see it. Drive.
Like I said, I think I was popping out to get something, ran out of something, had to grab something. I sometimes drive too fast. If you want, you can arrest me for that.
It's quite all right. I'll just arrest you for murder. But that's so I'm playing as Sarah, and my mother is one of these twins, probably Eve. And I guess I understand now why my mother, Eve, did that, because she decided that her twin sister was more important than Simon, and they just wanted to be together as siblings, and Simon was in the way? User is offline. Offline. I'll be outside. Log off and meet me over the road. Okay. Log off. So after getting the credits, you get that message at the end, which says if you're stuck, you can use admin random, or you can use the unlock, which is, I think, admin underscore unlock, to get that extra feature. So let's just do that. How can I log off? Maybe just here. Admin unlock? Account unlocked. Lovely. Now we can search some more. Pregnant. Aw. Oh, one new video. Good.
When she went home, Salmon had a birthday tea waiting. Afterwards, she told Salmon about me. Told him I was pregnant. She wanted me to move in with them, this sister who didn't know she had. She knew that instant. The look on his face. She
knew. So her twin sister knew before Simon that she was pregnant, and she was okay with it, interestingly.
Thanks. Please find Simon. I love him so much.
I'm sure both of you did love him very much. Sort of, in a very strange way.
No, he was as shy as me. I asked a friend to ask him out for me. We had our first date at the Odeon in North End. We went to see Risky Business. I had on my one best dress. Simon paid, he bought me a whisper, and I was worried about getting chocolate on my teeth. No. I mean, everyone loves Simon. He was so nice to everyone. He loves me. I wasn't in the house all of Friday night. After the argument, after Simon left, I left too. I was upset and I wanted to get away, so I took the car.
Is there more to the argument that we haven't seen before? Yes.
Yeah, I guess. I'm quite a private person and I didn't want to get into the detail of the argument.
That your sister got pregnant by your husband and your husband had no idea you had a sister? Yeah, that could cause an argument.
From when I woke up? Okay. I woke up, Simon was already up and he made me birthday breakfast of Eggs Benedict. We both had to go to work, so we saved presents till later. I got to work. Had some birthday cake, children sang me happy birthday, then I came home. The birthday meal was a takeaway, and Simon gave me his present, which I didn't mind. And after that, we talked about the baby. It turned into a big argument. Simon left, I was furious. I wanted to get as far away as I could and get some space to think. So I left. She sent him out of the house, kicked him out, called me up, crying, and I went round. I guess I had a feeling I could hear something was wrong in her voice, but I wasn't sure what it was. She called my sister on the phone. She never calls me that. My sister is gone. And she's never coming back.
What do you mean she's gone?
No, it's okay. The other detective has just gone to get your mom.
Oh, well, never mind. They were talking about coffee.
Yes, that's my birthday. Not one of the big ones, but I guess you can see that. It was my birthday, like you said. We were going to have a meal at home. We had our meal. He gave me his present. I guess I didn't like the present.
So you didn't like the present, and the other twin didn't mind it. We're going to talk about the present.
Well, a week or so ago. It would have been the Saturday before my birthday. You know, I get like that on the weekends. Have a lie-in, then want to get up and blitz the house.
As in, set fire to the house? I don't know what blitz the house means. Present. What was the present?
About 8 years back. It was a present to myself. I shouldn't even be drinking coffee with the baby. It's been hard trying to give it up. I think they say you can have one cup.
How terribly naughty.
Her story is that she'd waited for him to come back. She put on my wig, some of my clothes, pretended to be me. They talked. She'd enjoyed being me. He said he wanted to be with me. Then he took out a present. Another mirror. Just like the one he'd given her earlier. That unique present. She went crazy, smashed the mirror. They argued, screamed. He hit her. So she grabbed a piece of the mirror and just swung it round. She cut his throat clean open.
Oh my God.
She'd only meant to scare him off.
So that's it. That's the confession. The other sister cut his throat with the piece of mirror. Yeah, I guess it was a bad present, considering that she had her reflection sister following her all her life, and she had to live one single life with two people, and yeah, she killed him. Of course, we kind of already suspected that. But it was interesting to find out how everything happened. I'm still trying to find out as many videos as I can, even though I think that's the solution for it.
A wig? You mean, what type of wig?
You know, the type that you wore to impersonate your twin?
No, I've never worn a wig. What kind of wig?
The type you wear on your head.
This was nine, that night. I went round and she was waiting for me. She was furious and so angry. The kind of anger you can only have towards yourself. We screamed at each other, argued, cried, we fought. I hit her back, left a bruise. I had my wig on from performing and she tore it off. Eventually, we grew tired of fighting and I left. She was sat behind him. She had my wig on. She'd been there all day. And she had blood on her. And she was in shock.
Thank you.
given blood before. Do you need to take that for your records? Nothing like this has ever happened to me before. Blood. It's probably the worst thing that's ever happened to me.
Probably talking about her miscarriage, maybe?
Like I said before, it was 3. Something like that. I walked in. Saw Simon. He was on the floor of the living room. His throat had been cut. There was a lot of blood. Instead.
I noticed a thing about the reflections you see, like they pop up at some point or another, maybe when you get like some crucial information. And the video when we watched one of the twins saying that she slit Simon's throat with a piece of the mirror, the reflection that appeared then was actually surprised. It had a shocked expression. So that's pretty cool. But I'm thinking that, you know, the police did an investigation, because in the first video they were taking blood from her in this video. And maybe they found like fingerprints. Even though they're twins, I think twins still get different fingerprints, or I might be wrong. They might have the same fingerprints. Fingerprints. Ooh, big section on fingerprints.
Fine. I never had my fingerprints taken before. I once put my hand in the oven.
Was that intentional? Like, I once burned my fingers in the oven after Simon died.
Fingerprints.
Well, that was a good video.
Yes. Yeah. I would have cleaned them. I changed the sheets too. With the fingerprints in all those places. Could they have been my parents' fingerprints? I'm not sure how long they last for, but is that possible?
Not really, since they seem to have died a long time before you moved into the house.
Really? Go on then. Take the cup. Run your fingerprints. They'll match.
Ooh. She got upset. Evidence.
Rehearsed?
Yep.
You ask me the same question, you'll get the same answer. Is that your evidence? Of course I thought about what happened then. It's all I've thought about. My husband is dead.
Tell me more about the murder weapon.
The mirror. I can't remember. I put it somewhere safe. Upstairs, I think. I haven't looked at it since. Silverleaf? No. He normally silvers them properly. This mirror, it's supposed to look antique. The reflection isn't as good. It's the perfect mirror for someone who doesn't like to pick up the wrong reflection.
Okay, where did you get that from?
Look, on his clothes. That would make sense. He made it. By hand. I mean, he brushes the silver onto the glass. That's not how they make mirrors these days. He made the mirror. And he gave it to me.
And then I murdered him with the mirror that he gave me. Oh, so that was the murder weapon in the bag.
Fairy tales. stories about lost princesses, evil witches, magical mirrors and lost children. So you see, even before I knew the truth, I'd found it in those stories. I'm not sure where the dollhouse came from. I don't know if it was given to them or they inherited it. And they wouldn't have had the money to buy it. It was so huge. It must have been taken up to the attic in parts and then reassembled up there. It is a beautiful thing. Wallpaper to scale. Little furniture. The lights work. Mirrors, beds. Big duvets and pillows. We spent hours and hours playing in it. We invented all these characters and families who lived there. We wrote paperwork for them all. Passports, diaries, and gave them all really elaborate stories. Once, a moth got trapped in there. We'd left a light on. It was making the most horrendous noise. We tried to kill it, but it was tough. We ended up crushing it under a copy of the Arabian Nights. The legal stuff was completed very quickly. Hannah moved back in with Simon. Eric gave Simon the week off to help with the move. He decorated, modernised wallpaper curtains. Hannah insists the attic be left as it was, dollhouse and all. Simon never went up there.
Simon never went up to the attic where you lived? Like, you'd never notice another person in your house? I mean, you make some noise. You can hear bumps in the attic and wonder, hey, what the hell is up there? Maybe there's like a rat or a cat or something.
When we weren't together, we'd send secret messages by tapping out a code that we'd learn from a book. The knock code. Something prisoners of war would use. We'd tap them out on radiator pipes or the attic floor.
Unfortunately, I cannot read the code. I'm sure people can figure it out, or you can look it on the internet, what she's trying to convey.
It lasted about 6 months. I tried to carry on, but everything was different. Hannah insisted I not pretend to be her around Simon, let alone sleep with him. We didn't share him like the others. The rules had changed. Me living in the attic had become weird, in a way it hadn't been before.
Well, even though I didn't get all the videos, as you can see, I think I've built enough of the story to figure out how it happened and who these women are or how they lived. It's still kind of beyond me how you would even... Her parents and her husband. How could you not notice the attic and never imagine to go up the attic? It's just... That's kind of the only plot hole I can think of. But what an amazing game. This is one of the best, like, detective story FMV games I've ever played. Very captivating. You should definitely play it yourself and see if you can get all of the videos, because there, as you can see, there's still quite a lot missing. But an amazing ride with plenty of plot twists, and I didn't expect to be this captivated by it. I've been the Zen Bear. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next game.